This is the solution to quiz 8. Okay. So for part A, as a reminder, the formula for this is integral 0 to big T f of little t dt. And on this specific exercise, that is integral 0 to 6, and then f of t is 10,000 t plus 50 dt. And we can use the fundamental theorem to get that that's 5,000 t squared, and then plus 50 t evaluated from 0 to 6. And then plugging that into the calculator, that would be 5,000 times 6 squared plus 50 times 6, which is 180,300. Okay, so that's the total value of the money flow. B, the present value of the money flow, okay. The formula for this is integral 0 to big T exponential negative r little t f of t d little t. Okay, so on this specific exercise, that amounts to integral 0 to 6 exponential negative, and then the interest rate is 4.5, so 0.045 t, and then times 10,000 t plus 50 dt. Okay, so to evaluate this, we'll need to use integration by parts. And I'll observe that this factor here is an exponential factor, and this factor right here is an algebraic factor. And in the biparts heuristic, that's telling you that you want this to be u. You want the algebraic thing to be u. So u is 10,000 t plus 50, and then automatically dv is everything else, so that's exponential negative 0.045 t dt. From these two, we can obtain the other two parts of the biparts formula. So if u is that, then du is 10,000 dt, and if dv is that, then v is that same exponential divided by that constant, and then the right hand side up by parts is therefore uv, so 10,000 t plus 50 uv exponential negative 0.045 t divided by negative 0.045, and all of that from 0 to 6 minus the integral 0 to 6 of v du. So that would be exponential negative 0.045 t divided by negative 0.045 times du, so 10,000 dt. Okay. So now I'm going to try and simplify my life a little bit. I'll evaluate all this. Okay, so that, all of that evaluated at t is 6, 10,000 times 6 plus 50 times the exponential of negative 0.045 times 6. And then that all, that exponential divided by negative 0.045. Okay, so that first evaluation is negative, big number, 101.868.7.525. Okay, so let me check that. Negative 101.868.7.525. Good. And then minus all of that stuff evaluated at 0. Okay. That's interesting. So minus negative 4 ones, 1, 1, 1, 1 point. Apparently, infinitely many ones, so I'll just write 4 more of them. Okay, so now that's this evaluation, and now I'll simplify this integral. So 10,000 over 0.045. That number, and then this negative and that negative cancel, so then we get plus 6 twos, so 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 point. I'll add 3 more twos, so it's all twos, and then integral 0 to 6, exponential negative 0.045 t dt. Okay, so simplify this. So that number, negative 101.868.7.525, and then plus 1111 point lots of ones. So this first number is negative 101.757 6.414. Good. And then plus 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 point, 2, 2, 2, and then we can use the fundamental theorem for that. So that'd be exponential negative 0.045 t divided by that constant, and then that evaluated from 0 to 6. Okay, so negative 101.7576.414, and then plus, now let's evaluate that. plus 1168493. Okay. So, copying this up to where there's more room. Those two numbers. So -101757.414 plus 1168496.323. Adding those together, we get. $150,919.91. So 909, I guess. So therefore we could say that the present value of the money flow, rounded to the nearest cent anyway, is $150,919.91. And over here, the total value of the money flow, rounded to the nearest cent, is 1800300.00. Okay, so part C. To remind you, the formula is exponential r big T integral 0 to big T exponential negative r little t f of t dt. Now that looks like the worst formula of them all, but notice that the integral parts are the same. So this is literally the present value of the money flow. So to get the answer to this question, we just need to multiply by that. So the answer to this question is exponential 0.045 times big T, which is 6, and then multiplied by that number we already found, 150919.909. Which is 197699.7157. So that we could say that the future value of the money flow is 197,699.72, rounded to the nearest cent. Okay, so the answers were that one, this one, and this one. Okay, so that's the answer to part question one. Question two is a question just like a written homework question. And translating this, translated, what you need to do, the strategy is compute the future value of the money flow for both scenarios and choose the larger one. So, in a sense, that kind of seems like this question is going to be twice as hard as the previous question, because the previous question was we had to compute, in the end, the future value of the money flow once, and now we have to do it twice. However, on the previous question, to make your way through it, you had to use integration by parts, whereas for this one, you won't have to do that. Okay, so then the future value of the money flow for scenario one well, we'll do the same strategy as before, as I'll compute the present value of the money flow. So the present value of the money flow is integral, so 10 years, so 0 to 10, and then exponential, 7%, so negative 0.07 t, and then times the actual money flow, so that would be 1,000 exponential 0.03 t dt. And this is easier to do than question one because this can be algebraically simplified. So in the first place, that 1,000 can commute to the outside of the integral, so it would be 1,000 and then integral 0 to 10. And then we can combine these exponentials by adding their exponents, so that'd be exponential of negative 0.07t and then plus 0.03t dt. And then those add in a nice way, so that'd be 1,000 integral 0 to 10, and then exponential negative 0.04 t dt. Then we can just use the fundamental theorem. So that'd be 1,000, and then exponential negative 0.04 t, and then divided by negative 0.04, evaluated from 0 to 10. And then carefully plugging that into the calculator will give 8241.998849, which rounded to the nearest cent is what? So that would be 8242.00, rounded to the nearest cent. So the question that, you know, we're wondering is that that's the future value of scenario one. Will the future value of scenario 2 be more or less than that? Okay. So the future value of the money flow for scenario 2 Back up. That's not the future value. This is the present value. Almost lost track of what I was doing. Present value of the money flow. Okay, but then to obtain the future value of the money flow, we need to do exponential of 0.07 times 6 times the present value of the money flow putting that value in there and that would be equal to 6 was the years from the previous exercise. This one is 10, so this is times 10. So all of that times the exponential of 1659 3475. Okay. So now continuing. Therefore, the future value of the money flow for scenario 1 is 16,597.35, rounded to the nearest cent. Okay, that's the future value of the money flow for scenario 1. The question is how does scenario 2 compare? Okay, so the future value of the money flow for scenario 2, well, the present value, that would be integral 0 to 10, because it's 10 years, and then exponential of negative 0.06t, because it's 6% interest, times the flow, which is 1100, exponential of negative 0.02t dt. Again, this integral can be simplified, and I'll do two steps at once. So the 1100 can commute out integral 0 to 10. And then, wow, I'm having lots of problems today. So that's positive. The exponentials can be combined. So we get exponential negative 0.04t dt. So we can use the fundamental theorem. So that'd be 1100 exponential negative 0.04t over negative 0.04, and then from 0 to 10. Okay, so plugging that in, value of 9066 0.198734. So that's telling us that the present value of the money flow, the present value of the money flow is 9066, $9,000, $9,066.20, rounded to the nearest cent. But the future value, transporting this much money, transporting that much money to the future through an interest rate of 6%, would be 0.06 times 10, and then times the present value. So now we're going to put this value here. Okay, so times the exponential of 0.06 times 10. That gives us the value 165, so 16 and then 16,519 0.69116. And therefore, the future value of the money flow in scenario 2 is 16,519.69, rounded to the nearest cent. So now the comparison just comes down to this, between that future value and this future value. Which one is preferable? So in fact, they're quite similar, but the larger one is scenario one. So the conclusion we want to choose one for the same reason that we make any choice in these exercises, because you get more money. Okay, so then quiz question 3. So quiz question 3 is a freebie, more or less. So to remind you, we have this nice formula here, that exponential r big T integral 0 to big T exponential negative r little t f of little t d little t. So this whole thing, this bit of it, this is the present value of the money flow. And then taking the whole formula together, this is the future value of the money flow. So essentially what I did is I gave you the red bit. The red bit is that number, and then I gave you the rest of the numbers that you also need. So in the end, the answer is this: exponential, because it's 9%, 0.09. And then it's over the course of 8 years, so multiplying by 8. And then that red bit is that. So 55 16006.04. Type that into the calculator. And we get 11332266. So ha ha ha, 1326. Therefore, the future value of the money flow is what? 11,332,266.